sugar, spice, and everything nice, it's tea party time with Cory's Cake Dreams. From meringue swirls to lollipop twirls, we get extra sweet in the kitchen with Cory's acute and clever award-winning cake decorating tips. Then we set the table with gorgeous flower blooms, pretty teapots, and delicate china dishes. And we'll have tips on what to wear to a magical themed tea party, all in the next episode.
Presented by Dee Suihiro Electric Inc.
Aloha, I'm Valerie Joseph with Fashion Sense, reselling runway looks to the walkways of Hawaii and providing smart solutions to all your fashion needs. Hi friends, get ready for a sugar rush. I'm so thrilled to have with us today, my dear friend, the beautiful, the talented, the creative baker from the Hawaii Duel that won the Netflix Sugar Rush cake competition, Cory Nakamoto. Let's get baking with her.
Hi Cory, I'm so excited that you're here today with us. You're such an inspiration and you're so humble and you're such a hard worker and you've got so much passion for cake making. But I'm also really excited to learn your cake decorating tips.
Thank you so much, Val, for having me. I'm so excited to be here with beautiful Val.
Aww.
And I'm excited to start making some cake.
Let's make some cakes.
Let's dress this cake up.
Yeah.
So we got some colorful sprinkles.
Oh my God, I love
here.
These.
Yes. And yeah. Then we're gonna start at the base. So you just mush it against that cake. Press it, yeah.
Oh, that's an press interesting in. Feeling.
Beautiful.
Oh, and you're spinning it. Okay.
Yeah. And turn. Yes.
It's perfect. Okay. I'm just being way too excited.
Yeah. You can like press it and go up.
Oh
okay.
My gosh.
Okay. So we got the bottom.
Did you make this combination? It's so cute.
They're actually called unicorn sprinkles.
Oh my gosh.
Next, we're gonna drip the chocolate.
So we got gosh.
Chocolate. Then we'll start on the edge.
Okay.
So we'll drip a little and then you skip.
Feel like a professional baker.
And
like
you can control the drip. Like, don't squeeze too much and then squeeze a lot and space them out.
And you know,
isn't
me,
drip
like,
so fun?
What got you started in cake decorating?
So, I actually took like a weekend class at a craft store with my mom, and it was a cake decorating class. And I fell in love with cake decorating. It's been maybe about 12 years ago, and since then, I've done thousands of cakes.
Wow, what's the first cake you've ever made? Can you remember?
The first cake I decorated was in the cake class. It looked horrible. I thought it was beautiful, but looking back, it was horrible.
What
it was
what
a
was
gift
it?
Box. Ooh, beautiful,
I
look
know.
At that.
Oh, I'm so Watch excited.
Okay, now let's put some on the top. So just squeeze a lot.
What was it like on that Netflix Sugar Rush show?
It was a dream. And then we're gonna smooth it out a little. And you don't need these professional tools. You can always use like a butter knife or a spoon.
I think you might turn me into a cake decorator. This is so
yes, I
fun.
Can see you being one as well.
But you know,
make
I don't,
pretty cakes.
I wouldn't be able to bake the cake. I would just pick one up from the store and then just make it look all pretty.
Decorating is the best part.
Yeah, it's so fun. Is there a certain theme that you love to decorate?
Girly cakes. I love pinks. I love glitter. You know what? We're going to stick a cone in. So we cut a piece of it so that it can lean on the cake. So we're going to press it into the cake so it'll have an illusion like it's coming out of the cake. And the cake can hang on to it as well.
How do you come up with these?
You know, inspiration is everywhere you look.
Yeah.
I mean, social media, wedding dresses helps, everything. It just happens.
You can get inspiration from everywhere. I agree. I get it from everywhere.
We're going to put some ice cream in the cone. So we'll squeeze it in
there. So
it's
not real ice cream.
It's not real ice cream.
I've seen that looks like ice cream because that would melt.
Yes.
Okay.
Squeeze, twist it, and add a little bit of sprinkles on it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
More sprinkles.
There we go. And now we're gonna decorate the top. So we'll put right. like a little, and we'll put it right in. Okay, let's put some of these kisses.
Oh, and a kiss. Thank you. Thank you for that kiss. And you made these kisses.
I did make these meringue kisses. So we'll just stick them on.
Cool.
So you can always decorate the board. Okay. And then we also got some rosette.
Here. So cute, the rosettes.
Yeah.
And you made these too.
I did.
Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Wanted something total building automation. We chose LightCloud because of that reason. Our future is to be totally off-grid. I'm Daryl Suohiro, president of D. Suohiro Electric Inc. We are using LightCloud to control all of our lighting, and we were able to integrate it with our mechanical system, which controls our AC system and our exhaust fans in our restrooms and the warehouse ventilation. Our favorite feature is being able to totally control every light fixture in this warehouse. Summarizing LightCloud, total building lighting automation.
Winning the Netflix Sugar Rush reality show with Mad Cakes impacted your business. How did that You know, the messier, the better, the more fun I'm having. Going back to the show.
Going
How
back
has
to...
that show changed your life?
It's an honor. I mean, to have won that, I never imagined I would even have been on that show.
How did you decide to enter?
So it was my friend. He wanted to go on a show and he asked me to be his partner and I said, okay.
That's simple.
And they called one day and next thing you know, we're in California filming the show. And next thing you know, we won. Let's stick the lollipops in. So give me two pinks.
Okay.
And I like different heights, so. But again, you can make your own.
This is gonna be way
Need more things on it? Let's keep adding.
Oh, so if something arises, there's another opportunity for a reality show, you guys will jump on it.
Yeah.
How many cakes a week do you actually make?
Last week I baked about 40. It varies every week. But
oh my gosh, this is so good. Oh my God. Sorry, I got excited. When I get excited, I get a little loud.
I'm not a loud person, so I appreciate that.
Well, I feel like we need something in the center.
Perfect. We have the perfect centerpiece.
Ah,
this is some leftover icing.
So
beautiful.
Did you
rainbow.
Create this color combination?
Yes. You want to always color coordinate your cake.
Every artist has their own signature. And this is your signature cake.
Colors can make or break the cake.
So do you eat all of your cakes too? Do you taste it?
I don't eat all of them. I give them as gifts.
Oh, yes. That's so cute.
So this is the final part of our cake decorating.
Okay.
Here's
okay.
a cone.
Okay.
And I have a cone. I'll show you first.
Okay.
The ice cream scooper. And then you're gonna scoop it.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah. It's icing from the cake, so it usually doesn't melt.
Oh, okay.
And I'm gonna stick a stick in it.
Okay.
Just to hold support. And then this will just stick right in.
Oh. Are you looking at my scoop?
I'm looking at your scoop.
You're like, oh, what's wrong with my scoop?
I actually worked at an ice cream store when I was like 15, 16 years old.
So you know how to scoop ice cream.
You're I'm a scooper.
You're
yes.
a scooper.
Yeah, we'll just
and
use
I'm
this
not.
Word. It's okay. It's artistic.
I know it's not ice cream.
It's not ice cream.
But it's icing.
It's
but
icing.
You know, I can't help myself. I just can't help myself.
Go for it. We got a whole bowl.
Oh!
Beautiful!
Oh my God, that was easier than I
thought.
God.
It's perfect.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. And the last part, we're gonna bling it out. So this is gold, edible gold.
Oh.
And lemon extract.
Oh.
So we're making like a little mixture.
Uh-huh.
So that we can paint our
gold.
Look at that.
And where can you get all these ingredients? Is it something that we can pick up easily, or is it just from a professional baker store?
So edible gold might be a little harder to find. You can definitely find it online.
Oh my gosh.
At a lot of restaurant stores should have it.
By chance, when you were a kid, did you like to color books or
paint
with your fingers?
I did. I wasn't very good at it, but I did.
But look where it landed you. I mean, I'm watching you paint your cone like it's so, like you know what you're doing.
You're just as good. Did you color as well as a child?
I did. And you know, when I would color, I was really careful not to color outside the lines. Like I was one of those like perfectionists, you know?
Would you outline and then fill?
Yes, yes.
One of those.
I was one of those. But I like that the cake looks just kind of effortlessly thrown together, and it's just
it's perfect.
Perfection without perfection.
Exactly, exactly. And that's every cake.
Boom, boom, boom.
So, everything.
Oh, okay.
They have a name for it.
What?
Over-decorating itis. When you just keep decorating just keep adding and
I wouldn't stop.
Yeah.
I'll keep going. I'm over-decorating. I'm over the top. Are we done?
We are done.
Okay.
But I have a surprise for you inside.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
There's a surprise coming up, you guys. Don't go away. We'll be right back. I love surprises. Hi friends, many of us are spending a lot more time at home and looking at our space in a different light. Studies have shown that there has been an increase in DIY and home renovation projects. Today we are joined by award-winning realtor and my dear friend, Denise Miyahira from Island Pacific Real Estate, who's going to share with us her three areas of renovation that can help increase the value of your home. Hi Denise.
Hi Val, thanks for having me today.
You're welcome.
There are two major reasons why people do renovations. The first one is to upgrade any worn out surfaces, and the second one is to customize their space to their lifestyle. Mm. And so there are three areas that I feel can help increase the value of your home with these renovations. Number one is the kitchen. And so some of the elements of a gourmet kitchen could be things like the wine chiller. And if you have a chance, change out your countertops, but if you can't change out your countertops, maybe look at your cabinets and have them resurfaced or added handles onto them. And if you have the space, do a walk-in pantry. So this is all going to help you to create a clutter-free environment where you can now cook and concentrate on your recipes.
Ah, and I like having a big open space to work with too, because then I can scatter all my ingredients, I can find everything, and I feel like I can navigate easier. So I like open spaces.
And making yummy foods at
the
same time.
And making yummy foods at the same time. Okay, what's the next area?
So number two is the bathroom.
The bathroom.
And the bathroom is where you want to create a spa-like experience.
Yes.
And so some of the things you can do for a spa-like experience is look at your tub and see if maybe you have to update or change your tub. Maybe put in a different shower stall, and that could help. Or you can take a look at some of the mirrors that you have and see if they're tarnished and maybe they need to be replaced, as well as some of your fixtures. But for a small renovation, you can just go ahead and roll up some towels, put them into a basket, add some greenery, and make sure that you have nice aroma scents around, like lavender or maybe eucalyptus, to help you relax and get part of that spa-like experience into your bathroom.
I'm visualizing all of this and already feeling spa-like. I love that idea. Okay, what's your last area of renovation?
So the last tip I have is work on your air conditioning system and your roof. So here in Hawaii, it is extremely hot and humid, and it does help to have something like an AC system in your house to help cool you down. So one of the things you should do is make sure that you repair and maintain your air conditioning system at least once a year. Check out your roof as well, because the roof is also helping to keep your cool besides protecting you from the elements.
Oh, you know, I never thought of our air conditioning, cooling system, or our roof as an area of renovation to help increase the value
functionality of our home.
It is, absolutely.
Great tips, Denise. Guys, if you want more tips, head to our website. If you want more information on how to increase the value of your home or any other real estate information, contact Denise directly.
Thanks, Val, and together we will find the key for your happy home.
That's right, we'll be right back.
We wanted something total building automation. We chose LightCloud because of that reason. Our future is to be totally off-grid. I'm Daryl Suohiro, president of D. Suohiro Electric, Inc. We are using LightCloud to control all of our lighting, and we were able to integrate it with our mechanical system, which controls our AC system and our exhaust fans in our restrooms and the warehouse ventilation. Our favorite feature is being able to totally control every light fixture in this warehouse. Summarizing LightCloud, total building lighting automation.
Welcome back. Okay, Corey, you said you had a surprise for us.
I do.
I love surprises. Okay, are we making another cake?
Not another cake. Oh. Nope.
Wait.
Okay. Something better.
Okay, something better. Okay, what's
you
our surprise?
You get to eat the cake.
Ooh.
So, let's see. It's inside cake.
Oh my gosh. We
so
need to get in there.
You're gonna have to cut it.
Okay.
Now. To see the surprise.
Okay, so here's a quick story. My family won't allow me to cut pies or cakes because I'm a horrible cake or pie cutter. So, okay, here goes.
Destruction with cakes is the best thing. So just
enjoy
it.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm going in.
Go for it.
Destruction.
All the way through. Yeah.
Destruction with cakes.
Yes, it's always fun.
It's fun.
Right.
Yeah. Ooh, that felt great. Okay.
Go for it.
Oh, but my meringue's in the way.
That's okay. You can cut it. And then.
Okay.
Get your knife.
Okay.
Not quite under.
Here, okay. Let me help you.
Yeah, you
right
help me.
There.
Okay.
Okay. You ready?
I'm ready.
Ah! You got it. Okay.
Ah! Oh my gosh.
That's your
Wait.
Surprise.
Oh
layers
my gosh,
of colorful and more
oh my
sprinkles.
God. Look, it's sprinkles Wait. And layers.
Oozing. Accessorized from
Not
your
just that, out. Look at all the colors of the cake. Seriously, that was the best surprise I've ever had in my entire life.
I'm glad you loved it.
That I was amazing. Holy cow. Okay, wait. Can we eat the cake now?
Yes, yes.
I am dying to
cheers,
try this.
Cheers.
Oh, cheers.
Cheers.
That's cute. How do you not eat these every time you make it? Holy cow.
You need like Wait. Icing with it too.
Yeah. And the sprinkles.
I got the green.
Does every color have a different flavor?
No. But you can.
That would probably take you like 2 months. Oh my god. That's delicious. It's not overly sweet.
Mm-hmm. It's a cream cheese filling with vanilla cake.
Oh my gosh.
Rainbow cake.
I wouldn't change a thing to this recipe.
Really?
It's perfect.
Isn't it a beautiful destruction?
It's a beautiful destruction. I can't believe you did all this work.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Small progress each day will lead you to big results. In today's floor work progression, I have the Scorpion Straddle, which is going to take you through baby steps into that big result, your straddle. All you need is some space on your floor. Join me. We're gonna lie bellies down in a prone position. Now, from here, I'm gonna elongate through my back arm and I'm gonna bend through my front leg. This front palm is purely to help push me. So bend through your back leg and start to open up. I wanna open up and lead with that back toe so that my hip goes up towards the ceiling and it's nice and open and I can squeeze through my back glute. We're gonna take it back to the floor. I'm gonna do the other side. Elongate, this is gonna be my backside now, and I'm gonna press through my front palm. I'm gonna bend through my front leg, and I'm gonna open up.
my toe is trying to pull me away, and I'm opening my hip up to the ceiling. Let's go ahead, let's take it back to the floor, and we're gonna progress it. You're gonna elongate through the back arm, but make sure that you can press to the front as well. We're gonna bend through this front leg and press yourself up into a double 90-90 position and bring it down to the floor. And again, we're going to go in the opposite direction, pressing through my back arm as well as my front, bending through my front leg, and both my legs are gonna remain straight. My chest is now up from the floor. Let's take it back down and lead you to that big straddle and all the way down, bellies to the floor. From here, instead of having bent legs, we're gonna leave both of them straight. So, backside, I'm going to press through my back palm, press through my front palm as well. Leg is gonna shoot back behind me, opening up into a big straddle. Let's take it back to the floor. And now the other side, I'm gonna press through both of my palms. This is gonna be my front leg. It's gonna remain straight. And there we go. We have our nice big straddle. These little baby steps lead us into that great big result. Remember, always be kind to your body.
Hawaiian Coffee Body Scrubs. Moisturizing, rejuvenating, energizing, sun-kissed, alluring, beautiful, handmade in Hawaii with aloha, Coco Java.
Hi friends! So we finalized the menu, we set the table. Now the biggest question remains is what to wear to an outdoor tea party. Getting dressed up for afternoon tea is all part of the excitement. So here are some ideas that we put together with the help from our friends at Calista. Taking it from the top, one of the prized possessions of an afternoon tea goer is a fabulous tea hat or fascinator. What differentiates the two is that fascinators are typically attached to a headband or hair clip. Adrienne's artsy fascinator matches her chiffon coral-colored tea-length dress perfectly. We pulled her look together with rose gold metallic colors, from rhinestone studded shoes to a sparkly clutch and coordinating rhinestone drop earrings. An eye-catching look fit for a queen. Dresses and tea parties are a timeless combination. You've probably heard the term tea-length dresses. These are dresses that have a hemline that usually falls midway between your knees and ankles. Sarah's jersey knit dress is both a classic style and color that can be worn for many occasions. The rhinestone detail at the waist adds just a touch of bling, and we played off of that with rhinestone studded pumps, a matching clutch, and cascading earrings. Her tea party hat is elegantly crafted from lace and sheer fabrics. An overall classic look. Reach for clothing with the ruffles. Instead of dressing in bold colors and edgy prints, choose soft, timeless looks. Despite the slightly shorter than tea length, Haley's triple pleated ruffle dress is perfect for an afternoon garden tea party. The large bows at the shoulders and generous fabric of the bodice makes it a showstopper. We kept her shoes in a clear color so as not to compete with her dress and added strands of a beaded necklace, chain strap bag, pearl-studded earrings, and topped off her look with a glamorous tea hat that perfectly matched the color of her dress. Do you have a prom dress that still fits, is still in love with, not only because it has sentimental value, but because it's so fabulous? Do what Nicole did. Shorten the hemline and make it wearable for other occasions. With a dress this pretty and in such a gorgeous color, you can't help but keep it in your closet. But why not take it out for a spin from time to time? We paired it with stylish closed-toe shoes in an iridescent color to play off the stones of the dress. The clutch and chandelier earrings also have the same metallic vibe. And for the tea hat, a striking violet color that makes this old prom dress a new and stunning ensemble for a garden tea party. Choose simple and elegant accessories that don't overwhelm your outfit. Pick one statement jewelry piece, like a cocktail ring, classic watch, or gemstone choker. Look for an elegant hat or fascinator that matches your outfit. Since there aren't rules about what type of hat you should wear, the sky's the limit. Go for a big floppy hat if you're attending a garden tea party. And why not expand on the traditional finger food menu by adding additional sweets? Corey's signature cake is definitely the centerpiece accessory of this party. A tea party is a fantastic reason to get dressed up, and the main guideline is to keep it classy. Step into the Calista store where there are lots of stylish options that will make you feel comfortable while looking your best. Thank you so much for joining us. It's always great sharing with you. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, find us on Instagram and Facebook, or head to our website to send us your favorite recipes or questions. We'd love to share them on the show. Let's stay connected. Until next time, be fabulous, be beautiful, be the best version of you. We'll see you next time.
So you gotta stick your knife up.
What about
it there?
Join me. All you need is some floor space. All you need. All you need is some space.